was talking in the first part. But the Holy Spirit was like put in her mind to say, remember that Elisha is around. Hallelujah. So she decided that she must find Elisha. Maybe she locked up her words in the house. Because if she turned her back, they were going to take them. I don't know how far Elisha was from her. When she had to walk over hills and valleys to get to Elisha. But whatever it takes, she wanted Elisha. Elisha was her only source now. And whatever it takes, she had to go to Elisha. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So she got up. Sometimes I will sit down in our situation too now. We sit down until the cat come back to. She get up and she said, I have to go and find the man of God.
Hallelujah.
After all, we serve and serve. My husband served God. He was a good man. He worshipped God. And he served Elisha. So I have to find him. So she get up. She searched for him. And she found him. Maybe she sat down on his knees. Or on his feet. I don't know. But she said, man of God, you must know my husband is dead. You know he feared God. You know he lived for God. Hallelujah. Maybe he left some debt. I do my best to pay it, but I can't manage it. Everything run out. I know the creditors have come to take me two boys. Oh God, the holy thing I have left. I can't afford it. So I need help. Glory. Glory to God. She said, I need help. Glory. And the man of God said, what you have in your house? Hi. Sometimes people are like, we can't do anything, my brothers and sisters. But the man of God said, what you have in your house? She said, we don't have nothing. She said, you don't have any men. Only thing that she remember, all I have is like a pot of oil. Glory.
But as soon as little trouble come, we leave them and pay them.
know in trouble and God will appear in her mind. She has to do something to meet this deadline.
Holy Ghost!
My God, hallelujah.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus. The man of God, as I said, told her what to do. And she go back home. Maybe he said she hold up him because she went to the right source. The holy man could not help her. He said the holy man could not help her. So you go to the holy man. You have to go to the right source. The Bible said he's our refuge and strength and the very present help in trouble. You see, we in that church on the top and show you know what it has to be served. We must know him. We must prove him. We must put him to the test. I gave a testimony in prayer meeting on Tuesday morning of something that happened not that ago. Thank you, Jesus. There are people out there in the world who don't like Christians and they want to attack us and feel safe. They don't overcome us. But if you know God, you do something and you must be the victor and not the victim. Thank you, Jesus. Not so long ago, an individual sent a message to me to tell me that he was coming to attack me. It was the morning when Sister Hines, not Lucinda, the last Hines, was to be buried. And they had planned to come to the funeral. But I got to the morning and something wasn't right with me. And I said, well, can't go to the funeral today. You don't know what it was, but something wasn't right. And so I stayed there. And a little after that, I got the message that the person sent to me of what he was coming to do. What did I do? Sit around and cry? No! Did I call anybody and tell them no? Did I complain? No! I put something on the floor. I put it on my belly. Thank God, and I cried out to God. I said, Jesus, this can't happen. You are yeah. Sunday morning, Sister Marcia Donna stopped me on the song. She said, Sister Ma, I was led to pray for you over the weekend. Yes. Because God not only leave me now, he showed somebody